Hello, I'm Norbert Gleich, MD, and I am the medical director and chief scientist here at the CHR. My subject today is called epigenetics. You may have heard this term before, or you may have not. But epigenetics is a relatively new science, which didn't exist probably 15, 20 years ago. 20 years ago, we still had a very naive view of what genetics are. It was widely believed in the early days after the double helix was discovered by Watson and Crick and the genetic revolution really started, that genes were working in a very simple way. They had a function and they either fulfilled that function right or not. Today we know that genetics is much, much more complex than that. Not only do our genes usually have multiple functions, and these functions may interplay and gene clusters may work together to achieve yet other functions. But we also have learned that genes don't always work in the same way, at the same intensity. Genes can go up in their function and can go down in their function. And those functions are not only influenced by other genes, but they are also influenced by the environment. Indeed, it is the environment that largely determines how much a gene is either turned on or turned off. And that process, meaning the influence of the environment on gene function, not on gene structure, is what is called epigenetics. Now, why has that become such an important aspect of medicine in practically all areas of specialty? Epigenetics are important because how our genes function is obviously of crucial importance. If genes overproduce or underproduce, it can lead to a whole variety of medical problems. It even can determine lifespan. Therefore, this epigenetic processing is of great importance in disease diagnosis, management, and in our general understanding how our genes are working. And what we found out is that while our environment, whether it is that we smoke or not smoke, whether it is that we eat certain foods or don't eat those foods, take certain medications, drink certain drinks, are more in the sun or less in the sun, all of this matters and affects our genes in how well or how poorly they are working. But the most important time period in determining how our genes will be working throughout our life are the 9 months we spend in our mother's wombs. They are crucial. And this was first recognized when a study or when a hypothesis was developed that suggested that how a woman goes through pregnancy, in other words, how she experienced pregnancies, particularly in crisis periods like famines, will later affect the health of her offspring. Associations were made, particularly between famines in Europe and later increase in hypertensive diseases in those offsprings, in cardiac diseases, etc. So the intrauterine period is very important in programming our genes for the future. I'm raising this point here because especially patients who are considering using donor eggs are always asking the same question. Doctor, will this child have any genetic relationship with me? Since obviously the genetic mother is an egg donor. And my answer to the to those questions is always the same, and it is that from a purely genetic point of view, with all the genes, the female genes coming from an egg donor, this patient will obviously have no genetic relationship with her child. But that does not mean that she will not have great influence on how those genes will work during the whole lifetime of this child. Because this child will spend 9 months in her womb, and those 9 months will be of crucial importance in programming the genes of her child. And here comes really the most amazing piece of information. Not only does the mother in those 9 months influence the genes of her child, but the information, the programming of those genes that happens while that child is in the womb can then be inherited into the next five generations. Meaning that you as a mother, even if you have been using donor eggs through your environment, by you being pregnant, by you programming the genes of your child, you may influence not only your child, but your child's children and another three or four generations. So yes, even if you use donor eggs, you still have significant influence on your children's genes. Think about that. It may make your decision to use donor eggs a little bit easier. It was nice talking to you. Thank you.